morning and welcome to AM News on Television Nigeria at this time. I am Eunice Johnson. It's a brilliant Friday morning here in Abuja. First, the headlines. House of Representatives passes vote of no confidence in solid minerals ministers. Nigeria Army embarks on assessment tour of border communities in Cross River State. National Center for Women Development partners UNICEF on girl child development. High Court in Abuja grants bail to Senator Dinu Nnenaye. Details after the break.
Tune in and stay tuned to TVN, Television Nigeria, broadcast beyond boundaries.
Welcome back. The House of Representatives has passed a vote of no confidence on the Minister of Solid Minerals Development, Kayode Fayemi, and the Minister of State, Abubakar Bello Buhari. The motion of no confidence was moved by the leader of the House, Femi Badjabiamila. The House decision follows the refusal of both ministers to be present at a sectorial debate hosted to find solutions to the troubled Ajaokuta steel plant. The Nigerian Army has embarked on an assessment tour of the Nigerian communities of Danary 1 and Danary 2 in Bauchi local government areas of Cross River State. The tour is part of measures to protect the communities from harassment by the Cameroonian gendarmes. The General Officer Commanding 82 Division, Major General Adamu Abubakar, said this recently while leading a team of operatives to inspect areas invaded by Cameroonian gendarmes 4 weeks ago. On January 29, 2018, more than 80 Cameroonian gendarmes invaded Danary, causing panic. The Cameroonians claimed that they were fighting militants who took refuge in the community. Noting that the Nigerian Army will work with other security agencies to protect lives and properties of Nigerians in the area, Major General Adamu Abubakar urged residents to report any suspicion to the authorities. The National Center for Women Development, in collaboration with Blaugrana Sports International and the United Nations Children Education Fund, will be hosting the project UNICEF Legends for Children. This event will see the wife of the President, Aisha Buhari, conferred with the UNICEF Special Recognition Award and Certificate for her advocacy work, promoting the development of the Nigerian child. The UNICEF Legends for Children events are held to raise awareness and solicit the support of stakeholders in providing quality basic education and infrastructure for public schools.
This is all in support to aid the charity work and advocacy of Mrs. Aisha Buhari Foundation Future Assure Program. The National Center for Women Development and UNICEF, having recognized and appreciated the laudable project of the First Lady of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, is hosting this two-day event to highlight the general public this important milestone.
The two-day global event is scheduled to hold March 9th to 10th, 2018. The event will feature a charity football match with players as Ronaldinho, Patrick Kluivert, and other international players in a friendly against former Super Eagles players. The High Court of the Federal Capital Territory, sitting in Abuja, has granted bail to the senator representing Kogi State Senatorial District, Senator Dinu Nnenaye. In a bench ruling, presiding Judge Justice Olasunwo Goodluck granted Senator Nnenaye, who is defendant in a two-count suit filed by the Office of the Attorney General of the Federation, bail. Justice Olasunwo Goodluck, in dismissing the case, described the prosecution's opposition as based on inadmissible affidavit evidence. Senator Dinu Nnenaye was accused of falsely incriminating Kogi State Governor Yahaya Bello and one Edward Onoja in an alleged assassination attempt. The offences are said to be punishable under Sections 140 and 393 of the Penal Code, Laws of Northern Nigeria, 1963. The senator, who pleaded not guilty to the offences, is to provide 100,000 naira and a surety as bail conditions. The House of Representatives is ready to override President Muhammadu Buhari's veto if he withholds assent to the Electoral Act Amendment Bill, the amendments which had passed both chambers of the National Assembly awaits assent by the President. The current controversy surrounding the amendment of the Electoral Act follows attempts by the House to reorder elections ahead of the 2019 elections. The chairman of the Independent National Electoral Commission, Mahmoud Yakubu, had on Monday said that the commission would stick to its timetable. In a swift reaction, the chairman of the House of Representatives Committee on Media and Publicity, Abdulrazak Nandas, insisted that the House will override President Muhammadu Buhari's veto of the matter. The ninth edition of the Zuma Film Festival, as announced by its organizers, will hold in December 2018. The annual event is aimed at creating partnership and attracting foreign investors. The theme of this year is Archiving for Creativity. Organizers say the film sector contributes more than 1.5% to the nation's gross domestic product, as it is also a tool for peace and national unity. Nigerian troops battling insurgency in the northeast killed the remnants of Boko Haram insurgents in the Sambisa forest. In a statement, the Deputy Director of Public Relations Theatre Command Operation Lafia Doni, Colonel Onyema Umbachukwu, confirmed the development. The statement said that soldiers encountered the terrorists while carrying out clearance operations in identified insurgent camps around Chikide and Chinene. Meanwhile, two officers lost their lives in the encounter when one of the combat vehicles pursuing fleeing insurgents was rammed in by a vehicle-borne improvised explosive device. The deceased soldiers lost their lives while receiving medical attention. To curb growing incidents of loss of lives and destruction of property resulting from violent clashes caused by hate speeches in the country, the National Assembly is to introduce a bill to ensure death by hanging of any person found guilty of the offence. The bill also seeks the establishment of an independent commission for hate speeches to enforce hate speech law across the country. Sponsor of the bill, Senator Aliyu Sabi Abdullahi, Niger State, advised that hate speeches on grounds of ethnicity or racial content shall attract a jail term of not less than 5 years and a fine of 10 million naira or both. The bill also seeks to promote respect for religious, cultural, linguistic, and other forms of discriminations. The Rivers State Governor, Nyesom Wike, has flagged off the construction of the Odufo-Akoku-Omoye Road to link rural communities of Eche local government areas of the state. The project, which is aimed at connecting the affected areas to the economic zone of Rivers State, is a 23.3-kilometer road which construction, the government says, will provide 550 direct employment to the people. Flagging off the road construction, Governor Wike said the road construction will expand economic opportunities in the area. The governor explained that the project is a fulfillment of the administration's campaign promises to the people of the area. The Consumer Protection Council has warned electricity distribution companies against imposition of arbitrary charges on consumers. The Director General of the Council, Babatunde Ibukera, gave the warning in Abuja at a meeting with the top management of Abuja Electricity Distribution Company. He said that the arbitrary killing and group disconnection of electricity consumers does not consider the interest of those paying their bills. Babatunde Ibukera maintained that such actions and abuse of the rights of lawful consumers. The Director General of the Consumer Protection Council pointed out that consumers' complaints are centered around billing for electricity not supplied. And in business, the United Bank for Africa has signed a $1 million 7-year loan agreement with China Development Bank. The loan is to finance the development of small and medium enterprises in Africa. UBA Chief Executive Officer Kennedy Uzoka says the loan will enhance the bank's capacity to provide access for SMEs in 19 African countries. The partnership is hoped to boost economic activities in Africa. And in sports, Real Madrid head coach Zinedine Zidane has asked current World Footballer of the Year Cristiano Ronaldo to take a break from Tuesday's Champions League return leg clash against Paris Saint-Germain. But Gareth Bale and Karim Benzema are both included in the squad. Zidane, who addressed the news conference, said it is very important to always keep Cristiano in peak form. This is the second time in three games that the coach has excluded the Portuguese goal-scoring machine. Ronaldo also missed the games against Leganés on Wednesday, though Real Madrid demolished their opponent 3-1. To end the news, a recap of the major stories. House of Representatives passes vote of no confidence on solid minerals ministers. Nigeria Army embarks on assessment tour of border communities in Cross River State. National Center for Women Development partners UNICEF on girl child development. High Court in Abuja grants bail to Senator Dino Melahi. And that's the AM News on Television Nigeria. Before we go, I leave you with this thought. The value of a man is not a function of material possession, but of the content of his character. Thanks for watching. I'm Eunice Johnson. Have a good day.